Many Men, from Curtis 50 Cent Jackson's major label debut, Get Rich or Die Tryin', dramatizes a defining event in the rapper's life.
Now it's clear that I'm here for a real reason, 'cause he got hit like I got hit, but he ain't fucking breathing.
From when he was shot 9 times in May 2000, to his album's release in 2003, a host of events would propel 50 Cent into the stratosphere of pop culture, and turn hip-hop on its head.
I done made myself hot, so ain't shit you could tell me. Now niggas calling me the feature, man, fuck your money.
After signing to Columbia Records, 50 Cent's original debut, Power of the Dollar, was shelved, and his contract was terminated after his shooting. 50 took to the streets for his comeback.
To me, like, you gotta sit back and figure out how to market yourself. 'Cause when you sign to a major label, it might be 100 acts on that also. So now you gotta give them a reason to make you the focus.
In April 2002, 50 took leftovers from Power of the Dollar, added in fresh freestyles over hits like Wu-Tang's Y'all Been Warned, and released the compilation album Guess Who's Back. It wouldn't be long until the gatekeepers came calling.
At the Guess Who's Back mixtape, and I remember just listening to the first song, like, wow. It was like every single song that came on ended up becoming like one of my favorite songs.
That same year, Eminem and Dr. Dre signed 50 Cent to a $1 million deal to Shady Aftermath under Interscope Records. 50 and his crew, called G-Unit, then consisting of Lloyd Banks, Tony Yayo, and later on Young Buck, The Game, and others, churned out tape after tape of remixes of popular songs. No one's single was safe.
But I'ma drop those joints every month.
Okay, the street joints.
Yeah.
You know, the No Mercy, No Fear.
I'm not gonna stop. I'm gonna keep taking everybody's single.
50's the future.
And doing it over.
Like smiling and dimple on my face. Bitch, that's a bullet wound. I ain't mace. Yo, we can't stay alive forever. So shit hit the fan and we might as well die together.
50 wasn't the first to use this technique, but he left his mark. Legendary Gangsta Grills creator DJ Drama categorizes the mixtape game as before 50 and after 50, saying, quote, "Mixtapes destroyed the demo tape. Nobody cared about your demo tape anymore. It was like, what are you doing with your mixtape and how are the streets selling it?" As the hits kept coming, 50 Cent kept rising. An artist would copy his format to similar success for years to come. In the early 2000s, hip-hop was still recovering from the recent deaths of its two brightest stars, Tupac and the Notorious B.I.G. For hip-hop and music at large, keeping the peace was paramount, but not for the Southside Jamaica Queens native. 50 picked fights and wore a bulletproof vest wherever he went. His buzz grew with each tape and even led to a tour. Jackson, who rolled with a large, heavily armed crew, used his credibility as currency.
Niggas saying they gon' murder 50. How? We riding around with guns the size of Lil Bow Wow. What you know about AKs and AR-15s? Equipped with night vision, shell catches and F-bangs, huh?
The run-up to 50's debut was haunted by the murder of the man who discovered him, Run DMC's Jam Master Jay. While 50 was not involved, at the time, police thought the hit was intended for him, and, quote, went to a club in Midtown Manhattan where he was about to perform and asked them not to go on stage out of fear of more violence. The mystery over who killed Jam Master Jay has never been solved. Still, 50 needed a hit to take his gangster image to the mainstream. Wanksta had done well on the 8 Mile soundtrack, but it was another cut that would take him to the top.
Go, 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 shawty. It's your birthday. We gon' party like it's your birthday. We gon' sip a Cardi like it's your birthday. And you know we don't give a fuck 'cause that's your birthday.
The Dr. Dre produced single In the Club was released in early 2003 and topped the Billboard Hot 100 by March. To this day, it's arguably 50 Cent's biggest single. Get Rich or Die Tryin' also had two other top 5 hits. P.I.M.P.
I don't know what you heard about me. Woo! What else you can't get a dollar out of me?
And 21 Questions with the late Nate Dogg.
I love you like a fat kid love cake. You know my style, I say anything to make you smile. Girl, it's easy to love me now. I don't fight fair, I'm dirty, dirty. I'm from Southside Jamaica, Queens, nigga, you heard me.
How to Rob, his slender street hit set the stage for his career, picking fights, and his first target would be a rapper at the top of their game.
What would I be without my baby? The thought alone might break me. And I don't wanna go.
2001 to 2003, Ja Rule was one of the hottest musicians in the country, with 7 Billboard Hot 100 Top 10 singles. 50 and Ja Rule's beef dates back to 1999, and while the origins are disputed, it would define the rest of their careers.
Murder, I don't believe you, murder. Fuck around and leave you, murder. I don't believe you, murder, murder. Your life's on the line.
50 built his buzz on living his aggressive raps while mocking Ja Rule's soft melodic hooks.
Yeah, it's all fucked up now. What we gonna do now? How we gonna eat, man? 50 back around.
That's Ja Rule, punk ass thinking out loud.
Today, their beef's ongoing, but 50 declaring himself the winner back then chipped away at Ja's credibility, helping along his career's decline. Ironically, 50 Cent's R&B-friendly single, 21 Questions, became one of his biggest hits. But for Ja Rule, the damage was done. After 2003, Ja only cracked the top 10 once. 50 continued to target other MCs, aiming shots at Fat Joe, Rick Ross, DJ Khaled, and many others to lesser effect.
I've been patiently waiting for a track to explode on. You'd be stunned if you won't and your ass will get rolled on.
Get Rich or Die Tryin' dropped to universal acclaim on February 6th, 2003, and moved more than 800,000 units in its first week. The album would go on to sell more than 8 million records. In 2005, it was turned into a movie. 50 Cent would build off of this success and have a noteworthy career outside of rap, with acting, video games, philanthropy, sneakers, clothing, and soft drinks.
Vitamin water!
None of those other guys would do that.
The run-up to Get Rich or Die Tryin' was an exercise in the branding of the ultimate street hustler. Fans tuned in at every point to see whether 50 would indeed get rich or just die trying. I'm Jacques Morel with Genius News, bringing you the meaning and the knowledge behind the music. Peace.
Ain't nothing to talk about in the air, you heard me.